Hello everyone, welcome back. Today we are going to solve some questions of chapter 2. Our first question is, give the classification of bacteria on the basis of their shape. If we are talking about bacteria are prokaryotic unicellular microorganisms which lack chlorophyll pigment. The cell structure is simpler than that of other organisms and there is lack of nucleus and other membrane-bound organelles. Due to the presence of rigid cell wall, bacteria maintain its definite shape, though they vary as shape, size and structure. On the basis of the structure classification, shape classification, bacteria are classified into 5 groups according to the basic shapes. Those are spherical. One example of that is cocci, rod shape, bacilli, spiral shape, spirilla, comma shape, vibrious, and corkscrew shape, spirochaetes. 3 most important shapes on the basis of classification of bacteria involve spherical shape, rod shape, and spiral shape. Bacteria can exist as single cell in pairs or chain or in group, clusters, in colonies. Moving toward next question, list the uses of microorganism in our life. Where we use these microorganisms. If we are talking about uses of microorganisms, microorganisms are very, very beneficial to us in many ways. They are useful in our daily life as they are used in food, fermented food and beverages, medicines to produce antibiotics, vaccines, hormones, in industry to produce pigment, acid, enzymes, biofertilizers and biopesticides. For medicinal use, antibiotics. If we are talking about antibiotics, antibiotics are made up of microorganisms that kill or stop the growth of disease-causing bacteria. And in this way, it helps us to prevent from such diseases. Microbes are found in our body also where they help us to digest the food well. And moreover, these microbes help to ferment the food such as converting milk into curd, to produce bakery products and to maintain hormones in our body. So we can say in this way they are very much of useful to us in our life. Instead of this, these microbes are involved in recycling nutrients where these nutrients are recycled and further helpful to replenish nutrients back to the soil or back to the nutrient cycle. If we are talking about vaccines, our body has its own system of fighting against disease-causing bacteria, that is our immune system, which help us to fight with such disease-causing pathogens. But with the help of vaccines, some weak pathogens are involved in our body which tend to fight against such diseases. So, in these variable ways, microorganisms are useful to us. Your homework is to write and learn these question answers. Thank you.